Our memories make us who we are, but it's thought 30 million people today are losing them due to the curse of our time, Alzheimer's. But the latest generation of research has unleashed a new front in the war against this devastating disease.
Allows us to see the signs of Alzheimer's disease earlier than we ever could before.
We believe that this trial marks the dawn of a new era in Alzheimer's prevention research.
Scientists are confident that a cure is tantalizingly close. In an Alzheimer's brain, a protein starts to build up in the synapses, blocking the electrical signals and disrupting the flow of information. This protein is called amyloid beta.
For some reason, the brain can tolerate a certain level of amyloid for a number of years, possibly many years. And it's as though the amyloid, which may be driving the process, needs something else to then go on to produce that destruction of brain cells that causes the symptoms and the devastation at the individual level.
It's called tau. The new era of research is focusing on treating the disease in its earliest stages. This family carries a gene mutation which can be traced back to an ancestor who arrived from Spain 400 years ago. Dr. Eric Reimer's institute is focusing on the APOE4 gene because it's so closely connected to the way the disease progresses.
The leading theory is that it leads to the development of Alzheimer's disease by reducing our ability to get rid of amyloid in the brain.
Up until this point, people had to wait until they had memory and thinking problems or had a diagnosis until they were given access to a clinical trial. Now we are offering clinical trials to people who are at high risk to see if we can stave off the onset of the disease.
I'm very touched to be a part of that process.
But the new era also aims to understand what is happening inside the brains of sufferers as the disease develops from its earliest stages. Professor Fox has invented a technique comparing a sequence of yearly scans which track the progress of the disease.
The new technology has allowed us to see a window of maybe a decade before those symptoms, and that's where the new trials are starting to target. What we're seeing here in this area, which is the hippocampus, which is critical for memory, we see just full of tau.
Professor Matthew Walker from University of California is investigating how plenty of deep sleep could preserve our memories and help fight off the disease.
We wanted to explore whether that sleep deterioration in aging and in Alzheimer's disease is not simply a symptom of the process, but perhaps a cause of the underlying memory problems.
Sleep seems to play a crucial role in preventing the accumulation of amyloid. So Professor Walker is trying to find ways of artificially inducing deep sleep. Success could slow the development of disease and strengthen our memories.
I think there's a lot of excitement now because there's some new data that looks very promising.
Every 2 weeks, Floor goes for physical and cognitive tests, and she's given an injection, which could be the brand new Alzheimer's drug crenezumab, or it could be a placebo. For Dr. Lopera, the trial offers a new future.
Nosotros estamos mucho más optimistas, las familias están mucho más optimistas, porque durante 30 años nunca les habíamos ofrecido una esperanza terapéutica. Es la primera vez que se la ofrecemos.
The drug, called aducanumab, was what everyone had been hoping for. The results sent share prices in the pharmaceutical company Biogen rocketing. The trial showed that the drug was having a remarkable impact on the brains of people with Alzheimer's. The scan on the right shows just how effective the drug has been in removing amyloid plaque from the brain. But a major complication has now been discovered.
The main side effect that we saw with this drug in the clinical trial was a thing called ARIA. And what we see here is a picture of ARIA, and what we see is a whiteness here in the brain, which signifies edema or swelling in the brain. And that's not a good thing because the brain is in an enclosed space, and swelling can be harmful to patients.
Neil Corkery is now participating in the trial. He doesn't know whether he's on a placebo or the drug, but taking part has made all the difference. Recently, he was even able to speak off the cuff at his son's wedding.
I was like my old self. I really...
It was extemporaneous. Wasn't any rehearsal or written words or anything. He just got up and he spoke and it flowed. It was nice. It was really nice.